Your brain is sabotaging you and making you dumber, which is against its prime directive. Anthony here for DNews, and your brain is built around survival in a harsh, unforgiving environment. But unfortunately, those survival loops can cause us some harm in our safer, smarter, modern world. Here are three things that your gray matter is a little too black and white about. Have you ever kept watching a show week after week even though you don't like it? Or finished eating a meal at a restaurant even though you were full because you already paid and you didn't want the money to go to waste? That's called the sunk cost fallacy. That food was already made for you. It's as wasted as it's gonna get the moment it hits the table. You don't like that show, watching more hours of it doesn't make those previous hours less wasted. On a larger scale, the sunk cost fallacy can cause bad investments and keep people in the wrong relationships. Why? Brain, because in order to survive, early humans had to prioritize loss. You lose a home, you lose food, you lose a mate. That can mean death. Not losing is more important to us than gaining. Sunk cost takes place in the lateral front and parietal cortices, which are involved in risk-taking and aversion. When we are losing, our brain only thinks in terms of saving the situation, not what's best for us. Now, on the flip side of that is something called optimism bias. No matter what the odds of something bad happening are, we tend to believe it is less likely to happen to us personally. Divorce rates, for instance, in the US are about 40%, but newlyweds rate their likelihood of divorce at 0%, even if they're divorce lawyers. Smokers think cancer is less likely to happen to them. People think unprotected sex can result in pregnancy and, you know, STIs, but probably not to them if they do it this once. I won't get Alzheimer's. I won't get mugged. What the what, brain? Specifically, what the what, inferior frontal gyrus? That is irresponsible. But optimism is linked to our knowledge of the future. If we're smart enough to picture a happy life, we're smart enough to picture death. And constantly thinking about death and failure doesn't sound like the behavior of a growing, thriving species. So people who are hopeful survived in our early history and helped us reach all the great achievements we have here. We also know that stress has negative physical effects on the body, so optimists make for healthier, longer living humans. Finally, let's talk about one that I'm always trying to avoid, but I'm never sure if I'm doing a good enough job: confirmation bias. So we hang out with friends who have similar interests. We read news from sites that agree with us. We have a sense of beliefs that defines who we are, and we tend to only seek out or remember information that aligns with those beliefs. Other stuff just doesn't hold our interest. A 2009 Ohio State University study says that we will spend 36% more time reading an essay if it aligns with our opinions. It's more pattern recognition. Teaming up with like-minded people meant a stress-free survival in early society, but it's bad when it's applied to news, media, research, politics, because if you just keep confirming your own thoughts instead of seeking out the full truth about something, you actually wind up less intelligent. You may see this one a lot online. So, how do you avoid this stuff? Well, short of transcranial magnetic stimulation to parts of your brain, the best thing you can do is be aware of it and try to question yourself and your decisions. Have you ever caught yourself doing one or all of these things? Let us know down below and subscribe for more DNews.